In this video, I will show you how I send push notifications from my NestJS server using Firebase Cloud Messaging. All of the code I present is available in GitHub and the link is in the description. This video is part 2 of push notification series. In part 1, I explained how to integrate push notifications in Expo for iOS and Android. I will also make a video for the web, and if you're interested, subscribe to my channel. This video will cover initial server setup, adding Firebase middleware, request validation with Zot, handling device tokens, and finally sending a global push notification to all registered devices. But first, preparations. First, install NestJS CLI tool if you don't have it. It's useful for creating new project and adding new components. If you ever worked with Angular, NestJS feels to me like Angular in backend. And creating a new project, it will be called API. So NestJS is opinionated and inspired by Angular architecture. Like in Angular, you have dependency injection, you have modules, and there's a clear separation of concerns. CLI works almost the same. I need a Firebase middleware, and to access the Firebase service from NestJS, I need service account access. Every Firebase project has associated Google Cloud projects, so go to console Google Cloud and select your associated project. Go to service accounts and select the account that starts with Firebase. Click keys and create a new key. Save the JSON file in the root of your NestJS project. For the coding part, usually what people install is NestJS Firebase add-on, but I think this code is so simple, so I will code it myself. I need Firebase admin, and I can start creating Firebase module. It is automatically linked to app module. This will be globally accessible module. I want it available in all of the modules without needing to import it. And since it will be imported only once, it will be initialized only once, and that is important for Firebase service. And I want to export the Firebase service so it's automatically accessible to other modules. My Firebase service implements on module init method, self-explanatory what it does. My service account path is Firebase JSON. Not really clean way to define hard-coded values, but this is just for example. And I first have to check if it's defined. If it's not defined, it will throw an error. Otherwise, it will initialize the Firebase app. And it will be available as a private property. And from this app, I only need two modules. I need the authentication part, and that will be needed for the middleware. And I need the messaging part, that is for sending push notifications. Now I need the middleware that will use this authentication service, and I will create middleware and implement it. My middleware uses access to Firebase service, and the use will be changed. It will process incoming requests. It will first check if there's an authorization header. If the header authorization header doesn't have correct structure, I will return the unauthorized exception. If the token is not inside the header, again unauthorized exception. And the last thing would be verifying the token with Firebase. Otherwise, again, unauthorized exception. And I'm interested in the result of the verify ID token method. It will return the decoded ID token, I named it user, and attached it to the request object. This will not work in TypeScript because request does not recognize that property, so I need to add the typing. And it will be declared the global. Namespace is called express. User is the value of the decoded ID token. And when I go back, the error should disappear. I forgot to await it. Use is actually an async function. And this should be enough. I will apply middleware to all of the routes on the server. And I will do that from the Firebase module. Since it is a global module, it makes sense that it belongs here, because that middleware was defined inside that module, and this defines applying that middleware to all of the routes. After Firebase is set up, I can start handling device tokens, and those are the addresses to which a push notification can be sent. They are generated on client-side Firebase by Firebase Cloud Messaging after the user has approved receiving notifications. And they are refreshed from time to time, so any registered device token needs to eventually be unregistered. I will create a new module and a controller and the service, and everything is automatically linked to the app module. I think I will need to use that device token service from app controller, maybe. But before implementing device tokens, I need a handler for route for device token registration. Unregistration, I'll handle it differently a bit later. But I need the request validation. And for that, I use Zod. Similarly, like with NestJS Firebase, there is a NestJS Zod add-on that you can install. But I think the code is so simple that I will add it myself, and the dependency is installed. So now I need a pipe that will pipe the request parameters into a valid Zod schema, and I will install pipe that is called Zod validator, and the Zod validator will take in the Zod schema. It will be Zod type any. Metadata, I'm not interested in that. I'm only interested in the value. And I'll first parse the value. If it was not parsed, I will return the bad request exception with some information. Else, I will return the result data. And my function is called format errors, and there can be field errors and form errors. Well, and this method will be called here. I can finally throw a bad request exception that will contain a message validation fail, and it will contain errors. Now I can deal with registering device token, and I need a schema for request validation. Schema simply just expects that the token of type string will be passed in the request data, and I can use it in the service implementation. My service uses Firebase service. It needs a logger. It doesn't need a logger, but I like to log things. Device tokens will be a set, and my register token will just take in the register device token model that is inferred from the schema. It will add to the set. Set doesn't allow repetition, so one the same token can be registered as many times as I like. The controller. The controller will also have a logger in it, and it will need to access the device token service, and it will have the post register device token, and it will call the register device token, and it will not return anything. This by itself doesn't do anything. It's just an indicator. This type register device token will be in request body. It will of course be the type JSON, but it will not be validated unless I add the Zod validation pipe that I created, and it will check against the register device token schema. This method I'll call it from my application, Expo application, and it will be called as soon as I get the Firebase Cloud Messaging token. In the app, I will need to add a new environment variable. It will be called API URL. If you watched my previous video, it is located in the use device token. Here I get the device token, and I want to register it with my API. So it will be fetch a public API URL. The route is called slash device token slash register. It is a post, and the body is Firebase Cloud Messaging token, and in case the request returns an error, I want it to log. And this should be enough for setting the base for sending messages from server to the Expo application. If you're interested in the whole integration for the app, take a look at my other video. It will be in the description. But I have the registering of device token, but I need to add the logic for sending the message. So back to device token service. I need to broadcast the message, and I will create a new method. It will contain the title and the message, and I will spam everyone. But first, let's check if the tokens, there are no registered tokens. If there are no device tokens, there will be no sending and it will be ignored. Otherwise, I will be sending the message to, I will try to send message to all of the registered tokens, and I will send it as a batch, which means Firebase service messaging will try to send each or multicast to each of the device tokens. Batch response contains actually responses, which I can iterate, and everyone that's not successful will be removed. The token will be removed, and I will delete tokens and index and specified index. I'll just log. And this should be enough. I need to add a route handler. It will rather be added from the app controller. App controller needs access to that broadcast message method. And remember, at the beginning, I had an injection of user into request object. This is finally, well, I'll use it, at least I'll log it. The message will be user says hello, and I will spam everyone, and I will return as a result that the message was sent. I want to test it before I bootstrap the application, and to test it I need authorization header, and I will get it by requesting the JVT token from Firebase, and for that purpose I created some script that I can call from Node. My script is called getJVT. And my script looks like this. So it needs access to the service account that I use in the API. You need to provide the Firebase ID and Firebase user ID, and you can find it by going to console Firebase, go to authentication, user list, and copy your user ID. This is what I need to get the JVT token from Firebase. As usual, the app needs to be initialized. Prerequisite for this, it's convenient for me because I'm using the Firebase CLI, so instead of downloading the web configuration, I just called the Firebase CLI to download the web configuration for me. And why I need the web configuration? It is the only way to get the JVT token from Node.js. And this is the part that gets the JVT token. First, admin has to create a custom token. For that, I don't need the web configuration, but to get the JVT token that I can actually use to authenticate my requests, I need to sign in with that custom token and request the ID token. So let's try it. And this is the token that I can use. But first I need to start NestJS server. If I did everything correctly, it should start. Of course I didn't. And after fixing, the server should start. It started on port 3000. I will just call the curl and I want to say hello. Of course, as expected, the server returned an authorized exception because I haven't provided it the authorization header, and it should go through the handler. The route should be called hello. And now I get the reply, message was sent. But actually, message wasn't sent anywhere because there are no device tokens registered. For that, I will bootstrap my application. My application calls register and something went wrong. Well, I'm not getting anything, but I remember now that authorization header is very important. So here it is. And if I restart the application, it should register and it should receive the registering device token. Now if I send the message, my Android emulator should receive it as it did. Yep, it's there, it works. So this covers setting up the server for Firebase cloud messaging and sending the global push notification. Thanks for watching.